Hello friends, my name is Taufik and you're watching my channel Graphics 10. So in this video we are going to see a very interesting tool called as the Art History Brush tool. You might have known this tool, but most people think that this is a pretty useless tool or we don't have much use of this tool. But today in this video I'm going to show you that in fact this is a very interesting and very useful tool, and using this tool we can create really stunning paintings or painting like effect using this particular tool. So let's get started. So first of all I will select the Art History Brush tool and I will increase the size of the brush, and as soon as we start the Art History Brush tool we get some options. For example, we get this style option. So we have different styles in this particular drop down menu. So if we draw or apply this brush on this image, you will get this particular effect, and this doesn't seem that interesting actually. So I'll press Ctrl Z or Command Z for undo. Now we have different styles. Let's say if I select another one, so we will get some effect like this. I will press undo. And if we decrease the brush size, then we will get a better result, but still not good enough, because this is really doesn't mean anything, because this is nothing basically. We can't name this thing. So if we take this particular option called as dab, then we will get better result. So I'm going to use this particular option dab, but with a different brush style or different brush altogether. So but you can always try different styles with a specific brush, but for now in this particular tutorial I'm going to use this style called as dab, and I'm not going to change the other options like area tolerance. I'm going to keep it the default values. So presently they are at 50 pixels and tolerance is 0%, mode is normal, so I'm not going to touch any of them. So to begin with I'm going to change the brush first. So I'll go right over here and I'm going right into the legacy brush group. If you are not able to see this particular group over here, you can simply go to this particular icon over here at the top, settings, and you can simply click on this particular brush. So as soon as you click on this particular brush, this will show over here. So I have already clicked it over here, so it is already showing in this list of the brush groups. So I'm going to open this particular group and I'm going to select from the default brushes. Inside legacy brushes, remember, inside legacy brushes there is a group called as default brushes. I'm going to go into that, and I have a particular brush called as a chalk brush, and this one chalk brush which is 23 pixels, this 23. You can always select some different brush and you can try it out for yourself to get obviously different result. So first of all what I'm going to do is I will zoom it out a little bit. I'm going to increase the size so that we will draw some rough strokes firstly. So we will create a basic rough image first of all. So before applying the strokes, I'm going to make a copy of this particular image by pressing Ctrl J or Command J if you are using Mac. So I'm going to press and draw brushes, strokes rather, simply. So at first you won't get anything out of this, but we are only getting started with this now. So these are only the broader strokes to begin with. And you can always use brush settings if you want some variation. And in brush settings, I will close the rest. I will close this also. So in brush settings, if you want, you can always use shape dynamics to vary the brush size. But for now, I'm not going to use this option, but you can always try to get different results. So as you can see, the brush size is 500 at present. So I'm going to decrease the brush size now. So maybe by half, 200, or okay, let's see, 200. little less than half. So as we decrease the brush size, we will start to get more details of the image itself. You can already see. So on this particular image, we are going to focus on the object, which is this girl in the photograph. I will turn this off. This girl, we are going to focus on this particular girl. So we are going to draw in detail this girl's photo in detail, and rest we are going to draw it with broader strokes. So like this, I am going to draw this or apply the stroke like this. So as we start decreasing the brush size, we will get more details as we go along. So I will stop right over here, and again I am going to decrease the brush size. Let's say maybe little less than 190. So you can see already we are getting details of that girl's photo. And you can always try, if you want details in the background as well, you can always draw your strokes on the background. But I don't want the details in the background. I only want details on this person's, which is this girl's photo. So this will look something like this. And as I said earlier, if you choose different styles, you will get different results. For example, if I choose tight shot, I will get different result. But for now, this particular example, I'm going to choose dab. You can always try it out. You will get different result, but cool results, obviously. You can let me know in the comment section. So we are already getting the details in this particular area, because I'm focusing on this specific area. And I'm not going to draw it over here. Now again, I'm going to decrease the size, brush size, let's say 40. Now, as you can already see, we can clearly see the parts of this image now. We can already see the eyes, hair, cheeks, lips, all the details. So this is already looking like a painting. Or water painting, watercolor painting. And remember, we don't want this to be too much clear. Like if we decrease the brush size too much, then it will look like a real image and real photograph. So there is no point in that, because we are trying to make it look like a painting. So if we make it too small, it will look like a real photo. So there won't be any point in that. So try not to decrease the brush size too much. Keep it like keep it that much that it is only recognizable, but the details are still, they should look like a painting. So I will decrease a little bit more, let's say 20, and I'm only going to draw it on the specific area, like eyes, eyebrows, nose, maybe a little bit, and lips, and maybe on the jawline, so that it will properly look like a person's face. So that's it. It is already looking like a painting. I will show you before and after. So this is before and this is after. So this easy to create or convert rather any photograph into a painting, water painting effect. So do try it out. So now we only focused on this particular area in this image. So I will show you another image. So this is another image. And so now on this area, I'm going to focus on this boat, but we want all the area, because this is a scenic image and we want to focus on most of the area, because we are not going to focus on specific area, but still yet I'm going to focus on this boat. But again, I want some details of this background as well. So again, I will follow the same similar procedure. I'm going to increase the brush size now. and the brush size changes according to the image or as per the image. So this is a bit high resolution image, so I'm going to increase the brush size to, let's say, 800 or 900, and again I'm going to keep a copy. Control J, always keep a copy so that the original remains intact, it doesn't get damaged. So I'm going to draw it now. So draw it, and as I said earlier, you can always choose the different style to get different result, but I'm sticking with the dab style. And if you are wondering why I'm applying these broader strokes with this large brush, just to cover all the image area. But you can always try and skip these steps and you can go directly to a smaller brush size. But I think this gives the image a bit more depth or bit more details. Again, now I'm going to decrease the brush size, let's say to 300. Again, I want to focus on the boat, but again I also want the background as well, not as clear as the boat, but enough so that people will understand what the background is. So I'm going to draw it like this. So we are still not getting any details, so because we are not able to recognize anything thus far. So again, I'm going to decrease the brush size now, so it's 300, so I'll keep it to, let's say, 125. Again, I'm going to focus on the boat now. So it will look something like this. So slowly, we are getting the result and we are getting the parts of the boat now. They are visible now. Also this wooden section. So it will look something like this. Again, and you can always draw as much as you want until you are satisfied. So again, I'm going to decrease the brush size now. So it's 125. So I'll keep it to 60. As you can see, we are able to see the brush, or rather the boat, clearly. We can recognize the boat now. And we can also tell the background is a natural background which consists of sun and some trees and a water body, of course. As we are drawing a boat, obviously. And this looks fine to me. And you can, if you want, you can go further by decreasing the brush size even more. But I think this is good enough for me, because we can recognize this, this is a boat, and also we can recognize the background as well. And if you want, I will just do one more thing. I will decrease this, let's say, to 30, and boat. This will surely now will look like a boat. Also the reflection in the water. So this is, I think, looking like a very good watercolor painting. So this is before and this is after. So this is so easy to create, or rather convert any photo into a watercolor painting using the art history brush. So many people still think that art history brush is not that useful, but you can always try these effects. You will get some really stunning results, really beautiful results. So do try it out and use, as I said earlier, use different styles, use different brushes, and you will get different results. but interesting results and very pretty results. So do let me know in the comment section that what brushes and what styles did you use while creating these painting, wonderful paintings. So that's it for this video. If you like this video or if you find this video useful, do give this video a like and subscribe to my channel. So I'll see you in the next one. Until then, bye bye and cheers.